Hey, Lastic.
Hi, Ry.
What are we doing today?
We're gonna go watch the movie called Hide and Seek. Do you see the billboard right there? Is it a billboard? Whatever.
I think it's called a marquee.
No. Yeah, marquee. Hide
and Seek. I'm pretty sure that's called the marquee. Wait, Lastic. Uh-huh. Can I have a donut?
No, these are not real donuts. I got them from Disney.
Oh, can I have one?
Which one do you want? The strawberry one or the mint chocolate chip one?
The strawberry one looks real good.
Okay.
Okay, can I have it?
Yeah, take it.
I can't lift my hand up that high. My hand doesn't go that high.
Well, too bad. You're never gonna have it then.
Ooh, this girl's got the same outfit on. One of us is gonna have to change. Mm-hmm. Oh, she's going to change. Okay,
good. So coming soon, Scary Stories Ride. Stormy Night, Soot? Mothman Incident.
What?
Oh, I guess those are the new movies coming out soon.
Oh, okay. So this is a story game Lastic found. It's called Hide and Seek. Uh-huh. What does this girl have to say? Tickets. Hello, you've already purchased your ticket. You may enter on either side of the booth. Enjoy the show.
Okay, thank you. You kind of remind me of girls I would see in the Haunted Mansion.
When did I buy a ticket? I don't remember buying a ticket.
I bought the ticket and I kind of just snuck it into your pocket because I am awesome.
Oh, whoa. Good evening. Right through these doors, please. Enjoy the show. Oh.
Okay, thank you. Oh. Oh, it's dark. Okay.
I don't know why I got scared, because this is like every movie theater entrance ever.
Okay. Is this these?
Shocking. Coming. OMG, no. Oh, no.
Right here.
Never playing that game again.
Wait. Dan and Milani were getting married in a week. So they invited their best friends over. Can you finish reading it?
Over to Melanie's house for a party.
Uh-huh.
Melanie still lived in her childhood home, which was always their favorite place to hang out since they were kids. Whoa.
They all started talking about their favorite childhood game, hide and seek.
So wait a minute. When I saw a story game, this is not what I expected.
I didn't either. Can you read it?
They decided they just had to play the game, and Dan was picked to be the seeker. Oh, Dan, you better do a good job.
Dan began counting to 100 as everyone ran from the room to hide. I should come near you because I feel like our delay is actually messing up with me.
I don't know. Dan finished counting. Ready or not, here I come, he yelled
loudly.
What
do you think? Do you think Dan will find everybody?
Do you want to know what I really think?
What?
I really think that this is gonna go real south real soon.
Oh no.
He went through the house looking for all his friends. Uh-oh, that's a dark,
are you
scary
here?
Hallway.
Hey, are you here?
Oh, I didn't realize we could go into the scenes.
Oh, I didn't either.
Oh, cool. Hi, help you find your friends.
Hey, dude, are you here? I'm looking for my friends. Okay, not here. Moving on to the next one.
Okay, let's go.
Wait, what? Were you him? Is that what that was? Oh, okay.
Yeah. I'm acting.
Oh, he looked everywhere, but was having a hard time finding everyone. Well, you're just looking in the doors. You're not looking underneath the beds.
Are you here? No.
are you still him?
Yeah.
He finally found Gerald in the kitchen pantry eating pretzels. Wow, you're not a very good hider.
Yay, Gerald, I found you. I knew you would be near the pretzels. You love pretzels.
I'm milk. Dan and Gerald went back to the living room and yelled for everyone to come out.
Everybody, you guys should come out because I found Gerald.
Wait a minute. This is not how hide and seek works. You don't find
yes,
one person.
Yes, it is. Yes, it works this way.
You don't find one person. What's his name? Dan?
Yeah.
Dan, you don't find one person and say, okay, everyone else loses because I found one person.
Gerald, I feel like I have a conscience talking to me.
Lastic,
his name is Michael Gardner.
We're in the next scene.
Okay.
Everyone came running back to the living room. They were having so much fun.
Yay, that was so much fun, everybody, right?
Okay. they started talking about when they were hiding. They laughed and laughed. This is such a weird game of hide and seek.
Oh my gosh, you remember when I was hiding?
Oh yeah, we were just hiding. Oh yeah, you were so hiding so well. I only found Gerald.
Okay. Oh my goodness. After a few minutes, they noticed that Melanie wasn't there. Look at all their faces.
Wait a second. It's been a few minutes. Where's Melanie?
Wait, I want to give them all villager voices. Hmm.
think that's Dan. Dan's voice is mine. Oh.
Okay. Wait, who's out there? Oh, Melanie. Melanie, where'd she go? Everyone began shouting her name. Melanie, you can come out now. But there was no answer.
Melanie! Melanie! You could come out now, Melanie! Melanie!
Oh my goodness. Wait, Lass, I thought you were just one person's voice. Are you everyone's voice?
No, I was just thinking three people.
Oh, okay. Three people's voice.
Uh-huh.
They were all getting nervous now. Okay, let's split up and look for her. Oh, wait, that's you. That's you, Dan.
Okay. I think we should all split up. Well, now split up, like, physically, because that would kill us. But we should split up and look for her.
They all agreed and went to look for Melanie.
Oh, yeah. Yum, yum. Oh, yeah. Totally.
They searched the They searched every square inch of the house, but could not find Melanie. They looked through all the doors. Oh, this girl knows what's going on. She's looking underneath the bed.
Not here.
Not here. And not here. Okay, I'm looking underneath the bed, and I don't see anything. I just see dust bunnies.
Melanie, are you in the cabinet?
Lastic, we're in the next scene.
Okay.
She says, okay. Cheryl and Grace even looked in the attic, but Melanie was nowhere to be found.
Melanie! Whoa. Melanie, this is a big attic.
What is this?
It's a mannequin.
Barbara, mannequin! Without the same thing. Melanie's parents just got home from their night out. Dan told them everything. She's
Mom,
like,
Dad, Melanie's not here.
Oh no, what happened?
Wait, is Dan Melody's sister? I mean, brother?
I don't know.
Why did you say Mom, Dad?
Well, is it Melanie's parents?
I think it's Melanie's parents.
Oh, Melanie's mom and dad. Melanie's not here. I don't know where she is.
Okay.
She's still hiding.
An hour already passed, so Melanie's parents decided to call the police.
Only if I didn't suggest to play hide and seek, Melanie would still be here.
Lastic, what's the wrong thing to do in a situation like this?
Cry?
No, dance. Look at they're dancing.
Oh, they're dancing? Yeah. No, she's comforting her.
No, they're dancing. They're like, okay, well, if we can't have my daughter, I might as well have this dance.
One, two, three, one, two, three.
Might as well have this dance. The police searched the entire property and questioned everybody, but there was no sign of Melanie anywhere.
Okay, so I'm gonna question everybody. You guys all better answer truthfully because I need to find this girl, Melanie.
Oh, yeah, you can ask me anything. I'll answer everything
they
to the best of my knowledge.
A full report and put out an APB. You know what APB stands for?
A possible block.
They put a possible block, but
a
said
possible breakfast.
There was nothing else they could do at this time. They slowly left the house.
Yeah, I am putting APB, a possible breakfast, and maybe Melanie will smell the breakfast and come out.
Maybe.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Maybe. Oh. Lastic.
Yeah?
The next scene is the sad one. No one ever saw or heard from Melanie again. Melanie, you're right here. Is this Melanie?
Hey, I'm not Melanie. I'm losing my hair.
Woo!
I'm losing my hair. I'm balding.
You'll never find me.
You'll never find me. This is a really big set.
This is a really big hallway. I was honestly not expecting this hallway to be like this. If the next slide says the end, I'm gonna be sad. Okay, good. Dan blamed himself, thinking that maybe Melanie just didn't want to marry him, so perhaps she ran away. Wait, what?
Oh.
Since when was this a marriage proposal story?
I didn't... I was supposed to marry Melanie, and I did not know this whole time. But, Melanie!
Lastic, I have...
Melanie, you are the one for me.
I have something to warn you about. We're about to age 15 years, so you gotta give Dan a voice 15 years later.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
15 years later, Dan was a very successful architect, but he never got over Melanie.
Oh, Melanie.
Wait, it sounds the same. You have to give it 15 years
later. My vocal cord did not age, okay?
15 years later, Lastic.
15 years.
15 years later. My vocal cord just got a narrower and my voice just got higher.
I also got punched in the throat 12 years ago.
And because I started growing beard, which actually started coming up my nostril, my voice also sounds very nasally.
And one day, Dan's mother called him. She told him that Melanie's parents were selling the house. Look how angry he is. Give him an angry 15-year-old leader voice. Okay,
I can't
good.
Believe.
No, that's it. That's it. That's all we need. That's all we need. His heart was broken, but then she told him something terrible.
My heart is broken.
She told him that when Melanie's parents brought in a moving company to pack up all her things, they found something.
No, I want to keep all Melanie's stuff.
In the basement, they found a very heavy trunk and when Melanie's parents unlocked it, ..
What did you find? I must know. What did you find?
They found Melanie. That's where she was hiding. The trunk lid must have locked when she got inside.
I know. No, Melanie. Why didn't you scream when we were looking for you?
Dan, that's a good question. Dan collapsed and began to cry. The one place they did not check was the basement. No one had hid in there before.
It's all my fault.
Dan imagined poor Melanie calling out for help inside the trunk. Dan, help me, Dan. But no one ever came because he couldn't hear her.
Oh, I couldn't hear you because I was upstairs. I was actually checking the kitchen cabinet because I thought you would be eating chocolate in there because you usually do that at night anyway.
Android users are not going to be a big fan of Dan.
Oh.
Whoops.
Whoops.
Dan has nightmares about Melanie in the trunk all the time. He can hear her screaming to help hit for her. Oh, this is a trunk.
Yeah. Can you get out of it?
I'm in the trunk.
Get out of
it. I can't get out.
Oh, the other girl's pushing you. I'm in here! Everybody!
Oh, okay! Interesting. you don't know what that's about yet.
Yeah. Oh my gosh!
That's what that's about. Don't forget to visit the other attractions. Wait, that was it?
I guess so.
Oh, this was just a movie though, right?
Yeah, I guess.
We hope you enjoyed the show. You can step through the doors to re-enter the theater, X out to leave the game.
I actually kind of like that story, how we get to act it out. That was fun.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think we did, but you kind of made that the case by acting it out.
Yeah, that was fun.
So I think other people who play this game, unless you want to, they probably don't act it out.
Yeah, then you'll have to be the narrator and then be the actor. It's hard work.
Yeah, good evening. Right through these doors, please. Enjoy the show. Wait, we already did this, didn't we? Mm-hmm. Oh, we already...
Where are you?
I'm back in the show.
Are you back in the show? Come out.
Hi, I can't... Okay, hold on. I gotta go all the way to the end. Hold on. Oh, hi. There's like all the people in the party and they're like, hey, we should go play hide and seek. Oh yeah, that'd be so great. And then they're like, okay, let's go play hide and seek. And then the one person, Dan's like, okay, you're going to be the seeker. Okay, that sounds good. And then they all get picked. We're over here and they're all running away while Dan is counting. And he's like, okay guys, I'm ready to come. And then he finds one person. Oh no, he's looking through the house. They're like, oh, I can't find anybody. Then he finally finds one person. He's like, okay, I found one person. That means everyone else is the loser and everyone else must come out. And they're like, oh my goodness. This is so crazy. That was so much fun. OMG, where's Melanie? I don't know. And then they're like, oh my goodness, that's, wow, Melanie, where are you? Let's look for Melanie. Goodness, she's not here. She's not there. She's not anywhere. Wow, we can't find Melanie. Hopefully she's in the attic. Oh no, she's not in the attic. Okay, well her parents are home. We should probably tell them we can't find her. They're like, oh my goodness, let's dance and call the police. And then the police come and they're like, oh my goodness, yeah, we should probably do this. Wow, we still can't find her. That's so crazy. And then, oh, there's Melanie, the ghost. And then Dan gets all sad. And Dan's this architect 15 years later. And then gets a call like, OMG, are you serious? You really found Melanie inside of a trunk in the basement? She was in there and got locked. That's so crazy. Oh my goodness, I'm so sad. I'm gonna drop my iPhone right here because of just how sad I am. And then, oh my goodness, his reaction scene was a lot longer than I thought. Okay, now he's sad and dropped his iPhone. and he's still super sad. He's like, I can't believe it. And then there's the trunk that's haunting him for the rest. And there's a big jump scare right here that comes over. And then, all right. Hold on, Lastic. I'm almost there. Hi, I'm here.
Where?
I watched the movie twice. Yes?
Do you think I'm gonna win the Grammy?
Yeah.
Male actor?
Yeah, totally. I'm like totally good at it. Like, oh, I'm like, I acted as Dan and I was like the best actor ever.
Well,
I acted out the agony of losing my fiance, who I didn't know was my fiance.
All right, everyone. Well, thank you so much for watching today's episode of Roblox. Lastic Hide and Seek. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to leave a like rating down below. Subscribe if you're not yet.
You're peeking.
And we'll see you guys next time.
I see you're right here.
We'll see you guys next time for another episode of Roblox. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye.